Hello guys, welcome back. So in this video we'll be discussing how to perform curl operations from your Java Swing application. So here, before actually directly going with the development, I'll just show you what I'm trying to show today. So here you can see I have a form here, and in this form I have multiple fields. So I have data as well. So this data is getting inserted from this fields. And when I'm clicking on enter at the place of quantity, so that a row get inserted. So I'll just show you how it's done. Like sample product, say like 5, just enter, so you get the product inserted here. Okay, so I'll be showing this kind of process, but it won't be looking like this, but I'll be showing you the concept of inserting the data, deleting the data, updating the data in your database from your Swing application. But what I have used to do, so I'll be showing you the tricks and things what I have done for this. So here you can see I only have save button but no delete or anything like that. So how I'm actually doing that, very in a simple way. So I'll be showing you that. So just going to close this. So we'll create a simple JFrame with some fields and try to insert some data to database. Okay, so I'll just close this. I have one project. So here I'll just go to some existing frame. So I have some register form here. This looks fine. So this saves some of my time. Okay, so I'll just go this way. So I'll be adding a J table to write, and I'll try to insert this data, delete. This is a simple form with nothing to do. So we will try to insert some data from this place. I think I have done some insertion work, I hope so. We'll just see it. What's happening with this? Okay, we are done. So here I'll try to add one scroll pan which will actually have our J table in it. So here with the scroll pan is here, so I'll just copy this, scroll to this down, and down again. So this is our scroll pan here. I just don't want to make it to this long, and in this I'll try to add my J table. So design, so in this I'm going to add my J table. Where is the J table? Here it is. You can directly drag it like this. So here it is. Okay, my fields look very clumsy here. So at the time of submit, I think I haven't done anything here. So yeah, so here you can see I have done a simple submit data also. This is again save so much of time for me. So here nothing, very simple way. So here what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to validate the password. Okay, what is this in this? So password does not match. Actually this is from here. Okay, so here I'm actually trying to insert into register values and the parameters here. So the first will be register name, U name. So I'll just go to this connection, I think db.ie. So YouTube project, So it is in C NetBeans project. Okay, C users NetBeans, where is that? So documents, where is that? My documents, NetBeans project. So YouTube, sorry, not this, the YouTube NetBeans project and database SRC. So in this I have one database. Okay, here it is. So I'm just going to copy whole thing of this and just paste it here. Sorry, with IA / IA. So here you can see I have register, so which is having two fields in it. So first what we will do is, as soon as we submit the data, we will actually try to populate this data into the database, sorry, in the scroll pen first place. So I'll just close all of the other things, close all, close other. Yes, save. Okay, so registration form is very simple. So and the submit itself, we will actually, once we submit the data, we will try to populate the data. So for this I am trying to actually create one more method which will, so here public void populate data. So what are the unique IDs for me here? So here as of now I don't have any unique IDs, so you can actually use one unique ID here, but as of now I'll be considering phone as my unique ID. So in my case I have one specific UID, but here you actually this is not the correct way to use phone, because phone numbers can be duplicate. So you need to use one more column saying like ID, which will have a unique ID for every row, so that you can specifically pick that row and actually do manipulations on it. So as of now I'll be using phone as unique ID. Okay, so select star from user, so ID. Now I'll be just passing the string you. Okay, now so I'll just run the query where phone is equals to so and so. Okay, just copy whole thing. So when I actually run this phone number and this works. One second, I think this I need to keep in double quotes. Okay, this works. So I have this row now, so just copy as it is. So first prepare your string query is equals to this one, and actually we are working on the populate data, right? So let this also be, this will be useful at the time of updating, deleting. So populate data requires only one thing, select star from, so from here to here it actually requires a string query. So this is a simple query. Now what I'm trying to do is I'll just get the connection is equals to connection manager dot get connection, and statement, I don't have statement or what statement. Okay, statement java.sql st is equals to connection dot create statement, correct? So statement dot execute, so I need to execute the query to actually get the result set. So I'll just take result set. One second. So actually I need to mention this and try cache block. Actually try catch, so just paste it here, whole thing. So here I'll be just making a result set. What's this statement dot connection? Okay, so I got the connection. Actually the field, the properties was not loaded actually. So result set SULT, result set is equals to statement dot execute query. So in this query I'm just going to pass the same query here, so which is here is getting passed here. Now we have a set. So here I'm not going to use any specific condition like set dot next, because already the set is having the next. So here we need to actually get the table name now. So we'll just see where is the table name. So in the scroll panel it is here. So I'll just click on properties of this and change the table name. I'll just make it as PULAT, populate table. Okay, click on close. So populate table is my table name. So at the time of submit, so here I'm actually writing that, right? So here, so populate POP, so populate table dot set DB util. Sorry, we have a code called DB utils. Okay, I think I don't have that library in me. So yes, so to populate that data into J table, you need to have one jar file which is RS2 XML file. So I'll just add that library here, add jar. So in my location this is RS2 XML file. Just open it and save it as it is. Now I hope, so this RS2 XML is having DB utils. So using the DB utils only we will actually try to insert that. So DB utils, you can see here, dot result set table model, and we need to pass the set here. So what this returns, result set table model. Okay, and table. So one, give me a little moment. I just forgot what I have, how to populate the data. Just I'll refer to my project. So source and dashboard. Where is my dashboard? It's been so long actually. I'm not using this. So just on save, I'm actually inserting the data. So here we have a simple line of code. Okay, it's okay with the update. Okay, not update, it's with the show data after invoice. So here it is showing like this. Okay, so populate, this will be our populate table dot set model, and this is fine. Okay, so here populate table dot set model, and just add this model here and close it with one extra braces. So this is what, so we will actually try to call this populate data with one button. So I'll just keep here, this is okay, fine. I'll just increase the size of this and I'll add one more button. Okay, so here actually I'm going to rename this to view data, view all, I can say, like, just close it. And here I'll just on the mouse click action performed, and the mouse click, or you can directly work with my action performed itself. So I'll just write POP poplet data and I'll copy. Okay, and we'll just try to close the connections. Here it is here. So in the final block, so I'll just close the connection. Close. Try cache block close. Okay. So we will run our this project now. Register form run. We'll see if we have any issues running behind. So view all. So it throws an error. It says maybe database is already open. So I need to close this. View all. So that's it. So you can see I'm actually trying to show the whole data here. Now what we will do is, as soon as I'm actually trying to insert some data, I'll try to show that data also here. So you'll have some list of data here. Okay, so I'll just try to insert data here, and when I click on submit, okay, it is already submitted. So when I click on view all, you can see one empty data has been shown here. So that is inserting and showing here. Now what we will do is, as soon as I enter some data here, we will actually try to show the data here. Okay, now close it, and it is very simple thing. So when I click on submit, so as soon as the submit data is successful, means if it says record saved successfully, here I haven't mentioned any validation, so it is directly taking the empty values as well. So I'll just click on populate data method. I'll just call the populate method data here. Okay, now we will see, we will try to insert some data. Registration form run. Now I'll just try to add, I have some data here, so I'll just try to add some, like, hello world, and here I'll just add some XYZ. So YXZ and some YXZ. So hello world at gmail.com, and some phone number is must here in our case, because we are actually trying to consider this as unique ID, but I'm manually entering this. And address will be some sample address or demo address. So I'll just save it. This should actually populate here. So you can see the data is showing here. So I'm simply calling that method there. Now what we will do is, we will try to actually, so as soon as I submit, I'll actually try to clear this, all these fields also, that looks very beautiful. So instead of just showing that, so as soon as I click on these fields, I'll just try to edit those fields by setting them at these places and edit those fields. And when you click on submit, it will actually save the existing file, or else we can add one more button. I'll be using one of this button as update, so to update it. Okay, so before that, we'll try to write an update method. So it's very simple. So we are considering this as our ID, right? So select star from, okay, select, not select, we need to do update register set name equals to question mark comma username is equals to question mark comma password is equals to question mark comma, and confirm password is equals to question mark comma, email is equals to question mark comma, phone is equals to question mark, sorry not phone, I won't be updating the phone, address is equals to question mark, where phone equals to question mark. So this will be our update. So this won't work. It says you need to set passwords for this. I think something is wrong. Syntax error, SQL statement. Now this will work, no problem. So update register set username password confirm. Okay, just copy this and we'll just close this, and I'll write an update method here. So public void update data. So this will be our string query. So we have certain parameters, so we'll just write on prepared statement. Prepared statement PS is equals to statement. Prepared statement. I think it is connection dot prepared statement, right? Prepared statement. So the query is the same. Let me look into my connection. So before that I need to get the connection as well. So a simple thing is use try catch block for this. Prepared statement, okay. Now what we will do is we will actually try to get the connection here. Connection is equals to connection manager dot get connection. Now ps dot set, so here starts our name, username and all those things. So I'll just copy paste all of my things to just save time. So first is register name. So username, password is there, the section confirm password dot get text. So register email dot get text. So we are not using phone, so I'll just skip this, I'll just uncomment this, and this will be 6. Okay, so phone will be our, so sorry, I think this is also required, but this will be 6, this will be 7. So this will be 6, this will be 7. Don't get confused what I'm trying to do here. So name is nothing but our register name, and register uname is nothing but uname. So don't get confused when I property this. You can see this is register name. So this is actually going to our database, okay. So just go to the source code. So register name dot get text. So in our database I have actually created the fields, so don't get confused why this is name here. So in my database I have put the register name as name, uname, password, confirm password and all those, so on, okay. So register name, confirm password, and you can see I have 7 question marks here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, and first one is name, uname, username, password, confirm password, which is next is email, and address, and where parameter and is register. Okay, just a moment guys. Now, and the next one is register. Okay, so once this is done, I'm just going to execute update it. So ps dot execute will work, but to check whether this is executed successfully, just we can actually do like execute update. This will actually return int. So int I equals to execute update. If I greater than 0, then I'll just say a message saying that dot show message dialog, and this, and I'll just show one message data updated successful. One second, guys. So let's begin. So we'll just run the code again, run file. So actually I need to call this method update, right? Okay, everything looks fine, but first I need to actually populate this data in this place, right? So that we have to do it. So without doing that, how we can actually update it? We can't update it, right? So it's confusing for you, but I know what to do. You just see. Okay, so mouse click. So see here in the on the table, so to the left you can see this is my panel. In this I have this populate table. On this events, on the mouse click, so I'll be selecting one row. Okay, that I'll show it to you practically. Register form, run file. Actually, one second, why this is actually showing me error? There is some error in this place. I'll just comment hold this thing. It is giving me some kind of error at the time of project running. Okay, run file. So here, when I view all, I have this data. So when I click on this data here, this will actually select all these things like hello world, XYZ, YXZ, YXZ, and all these things should be populated here. Okay, so that I can directly edit them in this place and just save them, so that that gets updated. So we'll see how to do that. Okay, now just scroll down. Okay, right click, mouse clicked. Okay, so from first place I'll be actually trying to get those all values. So we have seven things, right? So I'll just get string name, or I can just write like register name is equals to populate table dot get value at which index. So index will be populate table dot get selected row. Okay, and this will be column 1. We'll see. Hope this works. I'm gonna type jtx field. One second. Okay, this is not equals to, actually we need to set text dot set text. So we'll see how this works first thing, then you'll understand how this is actually working. So what is the thing I have done wrong here? String dot to string. Okay, I need to mention to string. Okay, so I'll just run this and we'll see what happens. Just view all. So when I select this, so you can see XYZ is selected. So this is directly taking the column 2, but we should make this to 0. So I'll just copy all of this thing till here, and I'll just write register uname dot set text register confirm password, sorry, registered password maybe. So register password is the first link dot set text. So registered confirm password dot set text. So register after confirm password, I hope that is phone. Okay, let me check email phone address. Okay, register email dot set text, register phone dot set text, register address dot set text. So dot set text. Okay, so here the columns varies. Actually this is one, sorry, this is one, this is two, this is three, this is four, five, six. So we are working with indexes. So we have six here. So zero is counted as seven for us. So just run it, and simply we have all. So when you click on this, you can see everything is getting populated here. The same thing happens for everything. Okay, now what we will do is when we try to update some value. So I won't be updating the phone value because we are considering this as unique ID. So unique ID, so and this, all these things will, when I click on save, this should actually get updated at this place. Okay, now I'll just close it. And I'll go to my update method. Where is my update method? So just now we have written this update method, right? So design, so submit, so this I'll make it to update properties, and this will be update. Close. So when I click on update, this should actually take this whole fields and update that. So as soon as I update, I'm going to again populate the data. So at this place, right click, events action performed. So here it is, update data. So as soon as the update is successful, then I'm just going to populate the data, which will actually update the latest database, latest data in the J table. So this populate data will actually show the latest data. Okay, so just save it. Now run this. So first thing is view all. Just click on this. So I'm just going to save this to about, and I'll just try to update this. We'll see what happens. Okay. It says connection successful, but nothing happened because I'm not getting those fields here. We'll just see what was wrong and update. I'll just try to print the stack trace. Okay, run it again. View all this one. Update. So we have some error here. We'll see what is error. So invalid syntax, it says. We got the same error there also, right? So I'll just try to copy this whole thing and check what wrong I have done. Oh, here the phone. Okay, I think this would work now. Run. Oh, run, this is debug and run. Run file. So just view all, select the file and just update it to update. So update it. So data updated successful. Now this place you need to see about here, say the name at that place of username. So this has come to the second place. So actually when you actually work with the unique IDs, this will happen. We'll do one thing. To you can actually use orders to actually show this at the top list itself. So as soon as I have updated, this has come to the last place as the last occurrence. So as soon as I update this, this should also get cleared. So to do that, just go to your update method and call the clear all method. I have written clear data. Okay, I think it is clear fields, I'm not sure. Update data. Okay, one second, what I'm actually calling on the reset method. So reset, okay, reset method is reset, just update, and I'll just call the reset method. That's it. Now I'll just run it. I hope you understood, guys. Now we will work on the delete function as well. So I'll just click on view all. I have this data. So in this data I have nothing. So this will be demo name and demo user. So demo, demo password is demo, and demo @gmail.com. So 123456, and address will be something XYZ. Just save it. So we need to actually save this. This will actually save. Okay, so it has not taken. Okay, just remove this one. I no need to update the phone, right? Got it. So because we put the phone number empty, so it was looking for that phone numbers to actually update. So there was no phone number, right? So at this place, when you select this, the phone number is empty. You can do anything here, like demo user 2, and just update it, and you get the same demo user 2 in the update. So this is how. And next we will be deleting this record, and we'll see how it works. Just close it. Design delete is very simple. Okay, so I'll just put this reset to last, submit, update. And here I'm just going to put delete. Okay, okay, and close this at the last. Now okay, this I need to change, right? This will be to delete, close. This is very simple thing. This will also work on some specific ID itself, register. So delete from register where ID equals to, so in my case there is no ID, so I'm just going with the phone number. Phone equals to so and so question mark. Okay, now we'll directly use a try catch block. String query is equals to, okay, so we'll be just adding. So I just don't want to make this so complicated with prepared statement. Okay, so I'll just pass the phone number here. So register phone dot get text. You can do it this way also. So what's wrong here? So colon is fine. Unclosed literals, okay. printf statement. First we need to get the connection, right? Connection is equals to connection manager dot get connection. Get connection statement st is equals to connection dot create statement. So try catch block. I don't know why I'm using the try catch. So statement dot execute. Only execute, not execute query. Like we can use execute update as well. So execute will directly use with the boolean function. So we can use boolean here. Boolean check. Check is equals to, if check is equals to true, check double equals to true, then just write the option pane dot show message dialog, just null, or you can use this, it's best to use this, and write record selected record deleted. Okay, record is deleted. Or you can just warn him also. So here you can do like, do you want to delete it? So I have written that here. Just go to my events. Move this. Yes. Mouse clicked. So here I'll be using this as it is. Copy. If reply equals to yes option. So till here I'll be copying. This is nothing but if you are trying to delete something, then that could be very worst case that you might be deleted this amount not intentionally. So just to stop him at some moment saying that, do you want to delete this? So do you want to update, was the message there. So do you want to delete product? You can. So as I mentioned here, so when you select it, you can just write it populate table POP. Populate table dot get value at, so 0 is my value, right? So again this will be the same populate table. What I'm trying to do is that simply I'm using confirm dialog. So this, so you have a message to actually type. So in the message I'm actually getting the name also which you wanted to delete. Do you want to delete user? So get value at 0. So this will be 0. You will understand very well. So yes. So if this is yes option, then run this whole thing. Okay. Okay, then now when you click right click. So when you click on view, when you click on this, it says do you want to delete, or sorry, where is this gone? Okay, you need to click on this, right? Do you want to delete the username? Username, actually this is getting confused. No, will not do anything. So when you click on intact, so it says do you want to delete the user intact about. So when you click on this, it says do you want to delete user intact about, then if you say yes, so this will get deleted. But before that I need to do few more things. So as soon as this is true, then I'm going to call the populate data here and reset method. Okay, just now run it again. We'll see what happens. View all, select this. Now it, when you click on delete, it says do you want to delete users. So I'll delete hello world from this. Delete, yes. So something is not good happened. It has deleted, but Poplet has not worked. Something went wrong. I think this is something to do with it. Execute is time fun. If check equals to true. Okay, we'll see what this is actually returning here. System dot out. I'll just print this check as it is, and we'll see. Run this. This should actually show us what is the error message. I'll just try to delete this demo. It returns false. Why it returns false after deleting also? Boolean check. Check equals to false. This is not correct. We'll just go to our database. Only two users are there, so we'll just go with the execute update itself. So we will explore more about it. So we'll guess, so this will be int check. So if check is greater than zero, then we will try to do this. We'll see now. See, if one row is deleted, it must affect one row, right? So we'll try to print also this check. We'll see what happens. So check, run it, and we'll see how the delete works. Oh, something went wrong. Database is open. This creates a log file actually. Okay, view all, select this. So I'll try to add some new user. Reset here. I'm going to add some demo user. Demo user. So some 123123. So xyz@mail.com, and some phone will be some unique one. Okay, so Sam. Sample. Okay, just submit this data. So sample address has been done. So I'll just try to delete this. So I'll reset it. We'll see if it works fine. So delete it. Yes. Okay. Now use this deleted and it's gone. So we have discussed how to submit the data, update, delete, and reset is simple. That you will just select those all fields and set text to empty, and view all will actually populate the data, okay, and so on. So this is it, guys. This is how you can actually perform all CRUD operations with your database. So I think this session looks very quick, but if I've actually told you all this, creating the connections and all those things will actually take much longer time. But I hope you're actually aware of this. Things like creating connection, getting the connection, using the connection, closing the connection. So this video is very advanced. So just keeping all those things. So that's it, guys. So I hope you enjoyed the video. So we'll be working on more customizations, more look and feel things, which I have actually used in my application development here. in the dashboard, how these things are working dynamically. So we'll be discussing on these things more and more in future. But please don't forget to subscribe. It's a click away. And do like the video if you like it. So thank you guys. Thank you for watching.